BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester.
We're getting people to come to the city and realise what amazing talent we have here.
From the Worcester Music Festival.
Gives me great pleasure to introduce to you our first act here today. He's a Malvern-based dubstep producer, known as one of the founders of nintendostep because of his melodic 8-bit sounds fused with heavy synthesised bass. His real name is Danny Hay. Give it up for Dead Lung!
How's it going, guys? This first one's called Ignition. Inhaler. Thank you.
BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester.
We're getting people to come to the city and realise what amazing talent we have here.
From the Worcester Music Festival.
We're downstairs in the Worcester Arts Workshop as part of the Worcester Music Festival. It's kind of the place where you don't really want to be. It's like a bit of a dungeon. And outside, the sun's shining. It's like 72 degrees. But you're wearing black, dead lung.
Yes, I am.
First of all, you're kind of doing the first thing that I always say that bands should do. How often do you go to a gig and there's someone wearing a Led Zeppelin t-shirt? And you're thinking, how many times have you been to a Led Zeppelin concert and seen them wearing one of your t-shirts? So you're actually wearing one of your own.
Yes, I am, yeah.
Are there many of these?
A bit of harmless self-promotion.
Well,
you
it's got to be done.
No, there's not any at the moment. I'm hoping to get some done soon.
Like, maybe you should keep them to yourself.
Yeah.
I mean, I've got my Hereford and Worcester t-shirt on today, and a few years back someone went to an event and said, oh, can I have a t-shirt? And they then ended up like representing the radio station and they were a nutter. So maybe you don't want like phony dead lungs kind of... Right. Anyway, where do you get the name Dead Lung?
I was having a little kip one day. I woke up and I couldn't breathe. A bit scary, I know. And I was whisked into hospital and they gave me every single antibiotic under the sun. Somehow recovered and went back into college and all my mates and even the lecturers were calling me the kid who needed the iron lung. So I was called Iron Lung for a while and I found out later on it was already taken by somebody and I suggested to my mates and one of my mates, Joss, he said Dead Lung and it sort of stuck since then.
It's certainly a bit of a dubstep name.
Yeah,
music has kind of almost moved on and you've moved your music on with that as well. You know, listening to what you're doing now isn't like dubstep, which we knew it 2 years ago. It's
just
one arm in the air bouncing.
it's changed a lot since then. I mean, there's been a lot of subgenre changes since it sort of came into the limelight like 3 years ago. There's a lot more melodic stuff, there's a lot more of the heavier, noisier stuff.
Is that what you're listening to as well?
Yeah, a lot of the time, yeah. Not just dubstep, but it's a lot of different genres in the area. So it's like drum and bass and glitch hop and trap and things like that. So it's all like a big area of music now as opposed to just the one main genre.
You've got the same bit of kit as what Madian used in Icarus
yes,
and stuff like
that's
that.
Right.
What made you go out and buy that? Was it because Madian was
it? It was because of Madian, okay. Yeah.
So you had to do a bit of research as to find out what it was how it all works.
Yeah.
I noticed there must be some form of quantize as well because it must
bit, yeah,
be really hard to try and hit a button and keep it on beat, especially in dance music.
Yeah, it's extremely hard to do that. I mean, everything's got to be perfectly in time, so I have to do some kind of quantizer, which some people could say is technically cheating in a way.
It's not, you're still playing the notes. It's the
still
same as when you go to any studio.
I know, but still, I mean, some people may argue that.
You're not playing other people's music, which many people
are
doing. And talk me a little bit through that setup then. People in an audience just see loads of buttons. They understand guitarists, they understand singers, but they might not necessarily understand producers.
I mean, the kit that I'm using there is just quite hard to explain anyway. There's like, you know, eight rows of buttons. They're all kind of organized, like one section's all drums, one section's bass and all that.
And are they sample triggers? How does it work?
They're all audio files, so like little clips of audio. They vary in length though, so it's some of them you have to press quickly
And how do you keep your drums going without having to keep resetting it, or is that like a constant thing which is in there?
It's either a constant thing or it's on loop.
So I noticed that you could half the kind of time of the drum, you could double it, you could
stretch
things out.
Yeah.
And what then is it doing software-wise? So you've got a magic sequencer kind of
there's a magic bit of software called Ableton that's sorting
out. Okay, so that's what you're linking up to.
Yeah.
Are you doing this much live?
This is actually my first real life gig. Wow. I mean, I tend to do just DJ sets like in and around Worcester and other cities in the area. So, I mean, this is the first proper one.
You need to add that. That's your party piece, the main bit of your set, you know. As soon as people are going nuts in the main part of the night, it's like, actually, if you thought that was good, check this out. Where have you played then?
Not really in Worcester. It's sort of been around Worcester. It's kind of hard to get a gig around here as a DJ. A lot of the DJs around here follow the playlist of the top 40, so it's hard to get, you know, my kind of music and the music around it. I've played around in Cardiff and Cheltenham and places like that.
Yeah.
And I've got one in London.
Great opportunities and great cities to play,
especially
Cheltenham. What a fun place that is. You know, so much kind of different genres going on there.
Yeah, it's not really renowned for that kind of different genre as well.
They like the electronic music.
Yeah, yeah.
Worcester's very much, well, what we can hear in the background, you know, a lot of grunge, a lot of drums and stuff like that, But as soon as you venture off into like the Cotswolds, you know, or suddenly electronic music comes out. And tell me a little bit about what you're doing as well. We're not making music. Are you working? Are you at college?
Well, I'm going to university. I'll be there by the time this is aired out.
What are you going to be studying?
Music technology. So I'm still in the music area.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Well, you started playing the snare drum irritatingly, so we'll leave it there.
Okay.
And it's real pleasure catching up and good luck with the course.
All right, thanks very much. Cheers.
BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester.
We're getting people to come to the city and realise what amazing talent we have here.
From the Worcester Music Festival.
Thank you. This one's called Placebo. Thank you. This is my last one. Before I play it though, I want to say thanks to BBC Introducing for giving me this gig in the first place. I want to thank everyone for coming. Cheers. And this last one is featuring Catherine McLean, and this one's called Vendetta. Guys, my name's Dead Long. Good night.
Producing music so now it hurts. Performing live here at the Worcester Arts Workshop from Malvern, Dead Long!
BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester.
We're getting people to come to the city and realise what amazing talent we have here.
From the Worcester Music Festival.
I thought it was excellent, really good. I think it's different because he uses the soundboard. It's a bit different to normal people playing. I think it sets him apart from everybody else. I really like dubstep and dance, and I like all different sorts of music, but mainly dance music. I think he sounds like Skrillex, a little bit like Madian, because I know he uses the same sort of music board as he does. Also, Feed Me.
What's the best gig you've ever been to?
Creamfields, definitely.
That was recently, wasn't it?
Yeah, we just came back from there on Monday.
Who was the best artist you saw at Creamfields?
Tiesto, definitely. He was amazing.
I thought it was pretty cool. Great music for a party, yeah.
What kind of gigs do you normally go to?
I've seen Squeeze live. Don't really go and see sort of this, so it's quite unusual for me, but I enjoyed it. It's quite odd because there's no instruments as such. Lots of button pressing. I don't really understand it, but it looks cool. Looks futuristic and groovy, yeah.
What's the best gig you've been to personally?
The best gig I've been to ever?
Yeah.
That's hard, that is. That's hard. I saw Paul McCartney from the Beatles.
What's the worst gig you've been to?
Probably a school concert with some very flat singing.
Absolutely amazing. He blew me away. He's done very, very well.
Is it the sort of music you normally go to see live?
No, never. I have listened to it. I like to think I'm quite modern, but Dan's music today has blown me away. How good it is. And yeah, I wanted to get up and have a dance. You could definitely relate to this music at a concert, in a club, and I can see him going all the way with this sort of music.
BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester.
We're getting people to come to the city and realise what amazing talent we have here.
From the Worcester Music Festival.